When we think of a mass on a spring, there's only two numbers initially that we really care about. One is the mass of the block, and the other is K, which is a constant associated with the spring that measures its stiffness. For example, a rubber band's a sort of spring, and it would have a very low K, since it's not very stiff. The springs in your car, on the other hand, would have a very high K, because they're very stiff and hard to compress. Now, right now, this mass spring, totally in equilibrium. This is exactly where the mass wants to be. Let's imagine displacing this mass from equilibrium. So let's move the center of mass over to here. So we've displaced our spring from equilibrium by a distance that I'm going to call x max. And you'll see why I call it that in a second. Now if I pull this mass back to x max and release, what's going to happen is it's going to undergo a series of oscillations. In fact, if we assume that this surface is frictionless, it's going to oscillate forever. Of course that would never happen in real life, but let's talk idealized here. In fact, this mass will swing through the equilibrium position here and all the way back to a distance of minus x max from the equilibrium. So now you can see the reason why I call this max, because as these oscillations continue, this is the furthest from equilibrium that the mass will ever reach. Now what I want to do is analyze this spring in terms of energy, which we talked about a ton in the last unit. Well, it turns out that the potential energy stored in a spring is equal to half the spring constant K times x squared. X in this case would be whatever the current displacement from the equilibrium is. So when this mass is at the equilibrium, x would be 0. When the mass was over here, it would be x max. Maybe here it would be 1/2 of x max, and so on. And so if we look at, let's say, three possible positions for where the mass could be in its back and forth oscillations. Let's look at position 1, equilibrium. Position 2, this sort of midpoint. And position 3, x max. So I want you to tell me for each of these three positions, as the spring is oscillating back and forth, what kind of energy does it have at each of these positions? Check all the boxes that you think apply. And remember, we're talking about kinetic energy, the energy of motion, and potential energy, which in this case is spring potential energy, not gravitational potential.